How do we count things we don't know about? Like, how many forgotten candies are hiding in your couch cushions? Or how many weird life forms on Earth have we yet to discover? Say you do want to know how many different kinds of candy are lurking in the crevices of your couch. You could start reaching between the cushions and grabbing what you see. By the time you give up, you'll have found some of the candies down there, and therefore identified some of the different kinds of candy. But because you didn't find every single piece, you can't know how many kinds you missed. But it turns out you can estimate how many you haven't found with a simple piece of information. How often you're still seeing new kinds by the time you stop searching. One scenario is that most of the kinds you're finding are ones you've already found before. And in that case, there probably aren't a lot of kinds you missed entirely. But it's also possible that by the time you give up, you're still seeing new kinds regularly. That would mean there are probably still a bunch of kinds left down there that you haven't seen at all. If you know how many kinds of candies you saw once and how many you saw twice, you can actually estimate how many kinds you haven't found. Say there are 5 kinds of candies you've only seen once and 2 you've seen twice. Plug these numbers into an equation along with some other info about how many candies you've found overall, and voila! There are probably 3 kinds still lurking down there, undiscovered. Okay, this is kind of a ridiculous example. But all sorts of stuff is also hiding in the cracks and crevices of our planet. Recently, a team of researchers, including our very own tree ecologist, Peter Reich, used the couch candy protocol to estimate how many undiscovered tree species live on Earth. Instead of grabbing every candy they could reach, they grabbed data about every individual tree cataloged by scientists, about 44 million trees and about 64,000 different species, and calculated how many species have been seen once versus twice. The researchers ran these numbers through the equations and estimated that there are about 9,200 tree species out there that we haven't yet discovered. Which seems like a heck of a lot. I mean, in the centuries we've spent botanizing all over the world, we've identified about 64,000 tree species. Have we really missed an eighth of what's out there? The couch candy protocol suggests that's the case. And if you think about all the big biodiverse tropical areas that haven't been painstakingly cataloged, maybe our lack of knowledge about the natural world isn't all that surprising. Let's not sugarcoat things. We still have no idea what it is that we don't know. But at least we have a better sense of how much is probably out there, lurking between the cushions. This video was made in association with the ASCEND Project, a National Science Foundation-funded biological integration institute led by Janine Cavender Bears, Phil Townsend, and Peter Reich. The ASCEND team, which is centered at the universities of Minnesota and Wisconsin, strives to understand the causes and consequences of plant biodiversity in an era of rapid global change. They use reflected photons from the sun to study biological variation and model the processes by which variation at one biological scale influences the next, from organisms to ecological communities. In addition to advancing knowledge, ASCEND is training the next generation of integrative biologists to understand how life's variation is connected across scales and impacted by global change.